You still lag it, sir. It's been a long old day.
I am here,
He's
Vince.
still here. What a champ! First time casting an event like this. He's doing a great job. But we are into Nuke, Liquid, and G2 up against each other. And as I mentioned before, the loser of this will be knocked out of the group stage. They will be playing no further part. G2, I think, will be favorites coming into this. But Nuke definitely does hold some question marks, especially as Liquid beat Na'Vi 16-6 earlier on this very map. So, did Smith just fall to his death? What just happened there? I have absolutely no idea. Anyway, Pimp is going to be coming in with the USP. Lands himself the headshot on Heaven. And then, actually, it was just the roar out chest shots to finish off RPK. So, no easy life there for him. But Liquid will take the first round. G2 starting on the T side. This could be a bit of a nightmare for them.
That was actually a pretty interesting strat from G2. They smoked off
Short
Heaven
shot, why not?
and then pushed through ramp room underneath Heaven and just went up through Heaven through the smoke. Like, it almost caught off Liquid. It, like, just barely, like, whoever was in Hut realized they were flanking through Heaven. Did a lot of damage on someone. Someone actually just splattered all over the ground. And, you know, good adjustment by Liquid there to get that round. But I really like the strat from G2 there.
This is gonna be some like industrial levels of derp observing, by the way, guys. I'm giving you fair warning right off the bat. Okay, it's Nuke. Refresh your stream if you're having sound issues. Again, spam that in chat, please. Mods and all you good people. If it's a Twitch issue, don't worry. You'll fix it easily.
It's gonna be a good map for Liquid as well. I think
Oh,
this is
yeah.
like one of their more comfortable maps. They've been playing it a lot lately, so I think in terms of like hours and big matches, they have the most experience on Nuke almost. So I think this will be a nice comfortable map. Also, G2 pretty nuts on Nuke, so I think both teams feel comfier.
Nitro and Pimp are there with frags. Scream in the meanwhile, he's going to answer back with one of his own with the Deagle. Shox is joining his Patriot. It's Compadre on the ramp. Scream could really well get another one onto Elise. He's going to be coming round, actually jumps up, which is going to completely neutralize any accuracy that he's hoping for. And G2, I'm going to get swept aside. And I do worry a little bit. As I said before, Liquid have already got a great result today. And G2 effectively playing for their tournament lives on Nuke. I don't know, man. It feels like it's too up in the air.
Yeah, this is gonna be tough here. This might be like one of the first times I haven't seen a team lose the second round after winning the first pistol.
It does seem like that way today,
This
yeah.
is amazing.
It's been a lot of force by victories. It's been
Yeah, a
pretty mad.
ton. So,
RPK.
props to Liquid here.
Just going to be charging straight down into the vents. And Leech is going to be banging himself frags, but RPK, is going for that flank. And will be getting it for himself. However, instantly afterwards, he bites the dust, leaving Scream on top of Silos.
RPK barreling down vents there. Just sticking that plant. God RPK. Doing God's work here. Getting the bomb plant.
Good guy,
Securing the
RPK.
money.
Good guy, RPK. Securing that Skrilla. Smith's minus one. Brilliant. Why not? After he fell to his death
Oh,
from heaven.
yeah. Not a good start. I think he got TK'd as well, too, before he died.
Yeah, I think he did eat a couple of laptops from the rest of his team. Smith will be watching outside, just be trying to get back to, what?
Alrighty.
Hold on a second. Bruh! We just played a few rounds. What is happening?
Well, at least nothing happened, right? At least it wasn't literally in the middle of a round, like deaths happening. Who are we firing?
Brilliant. So, yeah, I wish I could give you some information right now, guys. I have no idea what's happened. I thought that was live. I'm not gonna lie. And considering that the teams,
simulation rig,
the teams were even saying at the start, like, you know, good luck, have fun and stuff. So I think the teams have seen that was live too.
And then
they were
someone
definitely
just
playing
decides
like
to
it was
leave
live.
too.
I don't know. This is absolutely mad. And now Elise is asking what's happened. I know you can't see the chat there, Eric, so I'll kind of read it out.
Oh, yeah.
RPK's mic just didn't work anymore. Well, that's not really a reason to restart, is it, mate? Just restart from 0-0. What?
Oh, wait, they did it themselves?
I have no idea.
I thought an admin accidentally, like, did something. I have no idea.
Wow. So, yeah, by all accounts, it's a mic issue that is the reason for this, this great banter. So we're just going to have to wait and see what's happening. They definitely played, what were we into, round three, I think? I think it was like a shutout 2-0.
No, this is going to be first gun round here, 3-0.
3-0, right.
RPK got that bomb plant.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're into the third round, and then suddenly things got a bit strange. So I'm not sure if we're going back there, if we're starting from scratch. I realize you guys can see the chat, but Eric can't, so I'm just keeping him in the loop. It is a little bit confusing right now, I'm not going to lie. It's not even really break down what we've seen. It's not a case that we're like 13-13 or something.
Yeah. Looks like someone else had the same issue, so... Can you unmute us? I see the chat now.
There we go. Sweet.
But good start for Liquid. I mean, they barely lost to anyone. So, I mean, building that bank up early on Nuke, having the Molotovs, having that utility on Nuke is so important just to stop rushes, you know. Throwing a Molly down at Squeaky, Hut, really just gives, like, one of the really strong strats of just rushing upper out of the picture. So, build that bank. Get the op.
Yeah, for those who just joined us, Liquid's managed to get the pistol, and they got a subsequent round as well, but it did include a bomb plant from RPK, so we're moving into round three with both teams on a healthy buy. Here we go. Round four, pardon me. With both teams on a healthy buy, and we are all good to go. All golden. Let's see how this one plays out. Again, Liquid wrecking Na'Vi earlier, 16-6, will certainly be in good shape, and again, I'm kind of scratching my head as to why GT would go for this map, but maybe they have something up their sleeve, maybe they have something in store.
Yeah.
Time will tell.
JDM has 5 assists right now. What a god.
Impressive.
Doing the damage. 3 rounds in, 5 assists.
Not at all. The team player. Elise will be going outside using that smoke as cover. 2 players ahead of him. Can he, had a footsteps to his right hand side as well, but down he goes. Pimp is now trying to make amends for Elige's lapse off the battlefield. That flashbang absolutely wrecks him, but fortunately he has the smoke to fall back into. Pimp does get a kill. He goes next up to try and defend this site all by his lonesome. Runs out of bullets, runs out of health, leaving Body up against Nitro. They have spotted one another. Nitro drops down, does hit the last rung of the ladder, so he doesn't take any fall damage. But a lot of time to play with. Body's in no great rush here. He can play the mind games, he can fake downstairs if he wants. He's actually going to just straight up commit to going downstairs. He realizes between the two of them he has the faster rotation. May have half a thought in his mind though. Did Nitro just go through ramp down to B? That couldn't be in the back of his mind, but I think he's going to realize at this stage that he's coming down the stairs, but Nitro still lands the headshot! Cut-like reactions, and Liquid will have a fourth!
Yeah, Body seemed a little bit nervous there, like, just being super loud, just running around. It went down, like, scrammed a hole clip into the door. I know you want to get a hole in that door, man, but I think your position is more important in a 1v1. Probably the most important thing in a 1v1 is just, you know, if you can have the enemy not know where you are, it's just so big. So, I mean, him just spamming the door, Nitro just lost out, okay, boom, dead. So, great play by Nitro, but Body, don't spam the door, bro.
Yeah, the element of surprise is so important in those kind of clutch scenarios. G2 do concede a round that they'll be disappointed with, and all things considered, they're 4-0 down. Scream is still 7-4. Dude is kicking up a hurricane of kills, but they're just not able to capitalize on that with rounds.
Yeah, JDM gets punished going aggro outside last round, missed a shot and was stuck in the open. But not deterred from that, he's going to actually be aggro again pushing radio room. So I like the confidence coming out of JDM. And, you know, the stars are aligning with, like, the rounds that are happening right now. Everything's going in Liquid's way, looking good. And they're getting a lot of information here pushing lobby.
Meanwhile, G2 are going to be coming outside using that smoke coverage to get down secret. Body will be taking point for his team. Yeah, three players strong. Four players make that, actually, with just shocks hiding around the back to make sure no CTs get around the back of his teammates. This gives them full confidence to just focus their attention down decon, also control room. Body's still going to be pushing in first. JDM is going to be holding on ramp, so GT can't afford to get too aggro, and there is JDM. The assist king converting into the outright frag, landing the headshot, overkill if anything. And now Nitro and Pimp are going to come in for kills of their own. Body's the only player to retaliate back in control room. And Smith's alongside him. The bomb's also dropped out in a pretty sketchy position just outside on the site. You must know the JDM site is trained around that location. Body's making noise. JDM will miss the shot. This is allowing Body to establish some kind of dominance on the B side. JDM goes back in again raw. That is surprising. And before the rest of his team can get close enough, the time is scarce. The Body should be able to get this plant down. The problem is what's going to happen afterwards. As there's going to be a whole lot of CTs up in his face. And it will be Nitro that puts him out of his misery. Liquid with a fast 5-0.
Yeah, they had a pretty good setup down the bottom bomb site. And, you know, Nuke is one of those maps where a lot of the time you'll die and you won't even know where you died from. Or, like, you won't have a chance to even shoot the CT because he just has a crazy angle on you. So, like, a couple of those kills they got, the terrorists had no idea. But that is the Nuke life.
A map that we're starting to see played more and more. What are your thoughts on Nuke personally? Are you happy with the changes that were made and the visual overhaul and everything?
I think the biggest problem for me is not even the map, but like the sound on Nuke. It's just absolutely just awful. And it makes playing this map like incredibly hard. Because I guess I use sound more than, I don't know. I just use sound a lot when playing, so like I feel like I'm lost on Nuke. There's just so much happening everywhere. Like they can wrap around the rafters. Like the sound just sounds so weird. Are they in HUD? Are they in lower sight? So I feel like the sound just needs improved on Nuke for it to be like a really good map.
I mean, sound is a massive part of CS, right? Without sound,
yeah, it just seems like a cluster.
Mm-hmm. I know where you're going with
yeah.
that.
Yeah, it's a mess.
I definitely agree. Nico with the incendiary, gonna stop the lobby push for now. Does spot the legs of Shox, but Shox is gonna be returning fire in kind. Loses 73 health, but still alive, that's all that counts. Pimp now, after losing Nico just behind this, puts a lot of pressure on his shoulders, he's got multiple angles to cover. On top of the hut isn't a terrible position. He's gonna go aggro! The ball's on this guy! That was surprising, to say the least. I guess it's some kind of desperation mode, like maybe fight fire with fire, I'm just gonna go hyper-aggressive. JDM has missed his shot into secret, and doing so has to back away. Obviously, planted point-blank range, puts down Body in the head. Finishes it off with Styles. Both Shox and Smiths are incredibly low. Do they have any real hope of getting this round clutched? It's looking less and less likely as every second ticks by. Nitro could get the drop on Smiths, who turned his back on him just at the worst possible moment, but Nitro wasn't there to make amends. Shox comes through with two kills. How is this happening? Shox, surely you can't on the 1 HP. Oh, Nitro is going to take him. It was so close, yet so far for G2. And another round goes begging. 6-0 now. But on another day, Eric, this could easily be a 3-3 scoreline.
Yeah, everything is going the way of Liquid. This is like the opposite of what happened with Liquid versus Astralis. Every clutch was going in the way of Astralis, and now Liquid, just every round. I mean, G2 had a big advantage there, and Nuke was definitely a map where, you know, a man advantage can quickly change. Guy just getting a 2k, 3k. Shox almost making that happen there. It had very low HP, happened to find JDM in the door there, but missed a shot, and just not enough.
Mate. You can tell I'm tired because I just derp maths like massively. I think I just completely whiffed the maths. GG, well played, boys. GG, well played in chat. Thanks. So, Elish is going to be the first player to try him for a kill. You should just never do maths at the best of times, but especially not after like 9 hours of casting straight.
Yeah.
That's just poor times. Awful trade, though. Liquid continuing to turn the knife in the back of G2. Down secret, they will progress. They've been here before. It's not really a problem for Liquid. They're happy enough to just give up, play more of a passive defense by and large.
Yeah, they seem comfortable, you know, just giving that outside and having a decent lower setup. Pimp is down here. I think Liege is also on ramp here, and they're actually clearing out ramp room, leaving lower and just going to clear out ramp right now.
Well, frags do get exchanged, but it doesn't really change a whole lot about how this bomb is transitioning across the site. Smith's going to come in for a frag right now. Scream still has his back turned to ramp. 35 seconds left. Bomb is getting planted behind the site. It's a forward screen, the safe plant. It's also a pretty decent position if he manages to get a player in decon behind them. Or Heisenberg, some people call it, which is an awesome call, by the way. I love that.
Never heard of that.
Really? I heard it the other day. It's amazing. I think it was Launders that said it. Scream, though, on the back of the site. Needs to channel some of those one taps. Not even required. The spray's on point, and Scream will get G2 their first round. In no small part to Shock, though, he does chime in for two kills himself. 6-1, it's about time. And you can see, even though they've only got the one round on the board, because so many rounds have been close, Liquid's economy is not great. So JDM's down to 1500, Pimp has gone for a buy with UMP. This is G2's gateway back in.
Yeah, I actually like this timeout from Liquid, winning 6-1, but this is such a big round, and they're, like you said, their money is a little bit tight. So having a game plan here, getting a proper buy-in, this could completely reset G2. So I like this this tactical from Liquid. It's not too often that you see a team up so many rounds and taking tactical, so it's pretty cool to see.
Yeah, just don't let things slip away too quickly. And plus, with their funds being in a pretty dire position, you can understand if they need a couple moments to just figure out exactly what they're going to get on who. There'll be a drop. Nova! Okay. Interesting.
Hmm. Okay.
I suppose with JDM down to such low funds, it's really all he could afford. But I don't know. Well, I'm going to keep an eye on Hiko. Yeah, I'm curious to see where he's going to run with the Nova.
Yeah, he actually does like the shotgun on this map, so.
Someone in chat just said, waiting for Hiko to go auto shot. You weren't that far off, so you get some props. Not too far off. Nova, of course, a lot cheaper than the XM. A lot of funds to be put back in Hiko's pocket if he's to land any of these frags, but he's whipped completely! Oh, Hiko, no!
Oh, no!
RIP. G2 right out onto the site. The Nova will not be getting anything done this round, and Liquid in a position now. Do they even bother trying for this? Doubtful.
No. Yeah, JDM saved this up. They have no kit, no armor on JDM. Definitely a save. Bring this into the next round, they can win it.
Yeah, so G2 are going to get themselves their second round. As I said before, though, on another day, this could easily be G2 even the lead, the way these rounds have been going. They've consistently got onto the site. JDM's going to punish Smiths for going walkies.
Decent kills from Liquid, but both kills, the people had Tech 9, so people chasing the Tech 9. Not that big a kill, but actually, someone dies to the bomb.
I suppose it wasn't G2's side, though, so it's not quite as detrimental. If it was Liquid losing a player to the bomb, I mean, that would have been a catastrophe, because the whole point of saving was to keep three players alive so they could drop and get a decent buy.
Yeah, they
actually,
did their job.
Drop, but they're not even going to bother.
Surprised Hiko doesn't even go for, like, any kind of pistol here, either.
Yeah.
Like, they have three rifles. You'd think he'd get, like, just a P250, because, I mean, there is a lot invested in this round.
There's a little surprise. We're going to have some kind of a cheeky boost onto the silo. I think we are. I think the CT's going to boost onto silo here. Nitro going. It's going to spot the Shadow. Smith, though, is up to the task and drills him with the AK. Down to 7 health. So, not very long for this world, you'd have to assume. JDM, the meanwhile, is going to be peeking back rounds with the AWP. Their Shocks goes in for a frag, and this is looking so bad now for Liquid.
They didn't actually know that Liege got boosted onto yellow there and was flanking. He killed one from up top, and then I think if he would have just patiently flanked, he could have maybe got one kill there, but he was going for like a super fast flank, and Shocks making sure every corner is covered. Just punishes the Liege for coming in fast.
Do I manage to get an AK as well in the hands of Pimp? So that's going to be a decent investment going through into the next round. It's round 10. If Liquid can hold on to both these weapons, different sides of the map. JDM's going to be playing passive and ramp. Meanwhile, Pimp is outside of secret. He does have, I believe that shot has spotted him. Indeed it is. But JDM's fine. He is sorted. He will keep the AWP. And that's the important one, right? Because he's got the Kevlar as well. 5.6k of equipment value. The rest of the team can buy. He could even drop, actually, depending on if he wants to go with more nades. And here is the XM. So the auto shotty is going to come after the Nova.
Yeah, it sucks to keep saving for JDM. Feeling like he's not having an impact on the round, just having to save every round, but you just have to do it.
G2 trying to explode into this round. Is it just hyper aggression? They've got the Mac 10 in the hands of Smith, so clearly, of course, head armor could very well be absent from Liquid. And it was, but unfortunately, as far as G2 are concerned, it didn't necessarily matter because Alicia's going to dome down Smith's. And with the smoke and the Molotov in the way of the ramp push, for now, G2 are frustrated and stuck.
Yeah, the way Nitro used his smoke there was so efficient. He actually had his teammate holding the right side of the U-Haul, and then he smoked the left side, and it just completely halted the attack from G2. So, utility work from Nitro on point.
Eerie standstill falls on the battlefield. Is neither team seemingly wanting to push just yet? You hear the wind, the tumbleweed in the background here on Nuke. Only one casualty of war will be Smith's. Momentarily silenced. Molotov to the back of the site will be body though, that does connect the shot. As Hiko comes in for the XM frag, he's still on top of the site on A, however, as the aggression is all on B. RPK is to be planting slap bang on top of the site itself. This is kind of rough to retake, to say the least, and very easy to hold off from a terrorist. Multiple angles out in the open. Scream goes in for the headshot. Of course, it would be the headshot. Where else?
And Alish, clean shot.
Who was really struggling on train earlier. Has the arduous task of trying to retake with the M4. First kill goes his way. Spot Scream. He does have a HE, so we can slap bang that on top of the site. Easy retake. Liquid have done it. The kind of an anticlimactic end to the round. I was thinking G2 would put up more of a fight, but solid play by Liquid.
Yeah, that was a good retake. I mean, the flank from the Liege is really what won them around there. Caught the one guy close to vent, and then he spotted the second guy behind the site. So once you really know where they are, that's like the hardest part, is not knowing where they could be. There's so many little corners, hiding spots. So the positioning, finding that out, is just so big from the Liege.
What do G2 have in store? Right back to the drawing board, they will move. Invested a whole bunch into this round. No warp though, interestingly enough. Here's an overpass as well on the T side. Smith wasn't that interested, by and large. Shooting out the ceiling light, ceiling windows, I should say. And already dropping down into catwalk. Of course, this is one of the additions to Nuke. It makes it a lot more accessible for the terrorists to get their way around the back towards heaven. Oh, it's going to be a lead for two frags and a third as well. Doing some serious work from secret. Was not expecting him to get any more than just the one.
Yeah, that third one was absolutely insane. I didn't even see it.
Just caught the end of it. Great play by Elish. Single-handedly turning this round on its head for G2. Have invested the majority of their funds into this. And now it's on screen. He's got time to play with. He's got the bomb. But not a whole lot else going for him. Try and move his way towards A. Actually decides better of it. Outside. And there is the head just peeking up from outside heaven. JDM, though, is holding the same angle that we've seen him time and time again with the AWP. Leg Scream down to 16. He will fall. Scream, surely you can't get this next kill. This would be ridiculous. JDM will finish him off with the USP. 8-3 now the scoreline.
Yeah, this is a good job from Liquid. And I think they're actually going to need a really big half here because I'm thinking G2 is going to lock down their CT side as well. So every round Liquid can get here is massive.
Man, Alicia's on 17-6. Dude's on fire right now.
Yeah, definitely Liquid's best player by far.
because why was so surprised earlier when he was struggling so much? I mean, he was towards the bottom of the scoreboard, which is very rare. So it's good to see him back in winning ways. That seems like it would be quite dangerous, you know, just like big shards of glass landing on your head.
Yeah.
Pimp's just got glass falling all around him. I'd be crapping my pants if I was him in real life, but... He's gonna back himself off to the site. He goes there alongside in this double spray down the firing range. Is he in effect? And it's gonna be going the way of Liquid once more. Body's gonna be peeking. Finds himself put down. All too easy for Liquid. 3 kills for Hiko. And a timeout will be called. GT want to make sure they come into this half with at least 5 rounds. You've got to feel like this one's unlikely to yield anything, but it's the next round.
That was such a drilled execute from G2. I was watching the squeaky execute. They had like a nade that blew open the door, a Molotov Asian vent, you know, really good synchronized flashes. But I mean, still going up into that upper bomb site is just so tough. Even with like the most perfect execute, like they're going to be running through a tiny little corridor that's smoked off and just get lined up. So even with like, you know, a really good execute on that site, you could just see them, that Hiko and Pimp really just locked it down and really didn't even sweat there. But it was looking like amazing. I was like, oh, G2's gonna get into the bomb site, they're gonna be blind, but nope. Liquid locking it down.
Mid to high $2,000. Scream on 3.6k. Be surprising if he didn't invest in something like a Deagle, I would imagine. P250 instead. Okay. P250 and Kevlar as opposed to the Deagle. It makes a lot more sense. If they do get a weapon, they can put it across into his hands and then maybe he can make magical things happen. Again, not for the first time we're seeing G2 occupy onto top silo.
All 5 players. We've never actually seen them wrap the rafters to heaven, right?
Yeah.
Which is something VP does a lot.
Yeah, this could be the time, you know. They're all coming through, but another JDM typically does occupy outside with his AWP. Leech could be there again for more frags with his AK-47. It's looking good. They're lining up for him and he's knocking them down. JDM does come back in with a sidearm, leaving Scream, and enough to mention P250 and Kevlar, but he gets completely drilled by Pimp. 10-3. G2 will have another buy, though.
Yeah, they're just trying to get like really close into the face of the people in heaven, under heaven. But I mean, to get there is so far that, I mean, they just lost everyone and got a couple frags, one frag or whatnot, but the stretch for that round to work.
Similar setup to what we've seen them do time and time again. Shox has picked up the AWP, interestingly, not Smith's.
Yeah, Shox actually ran right to the door, just opened it, boom, shot Hiko right through the fire, or Pimp right through the fire.
Rough day at the office then for Pimp in on 14. Penultimate rounds. How are G2 going to end this half? 5 rounds could be good enough. 3, probably not. Side. Scream is on top of the vent, or at least Smith was for a few moments. Smith's now going to be pushing his way in first with the AK-47. See if he can get some entry frags for himself. It's not going to happen this time around. Hiko, meanwhile, is doing some serious work with that M4A4. Not quite another one. Scream comes in with a headshot of his own. Elige now should be odds on favourite to hold off for a little while longer. That one tap is absolutely beautiful, though. And Scream, with 40 seconds, just maybe, not quite. Nitro peaks around at the right moment, 11-3, but Scream with that one tap, man.
Yeah, he didn't know where Nitro was there. Nitro able to just peek out, secure that. Almost getting scared there with JDM missing that shot, opportunity to take him down, but not knowing where Nitro is. It's the nuke life.
Oh, rough day for RPK, 1-11. You hate to see it.
Yeah, not having a fun one.
Seems like outside is now the call for G2. Wanted to end in winning ways. Smith's going to be taking the brunt of the damage. He has to feel going in first. Leash has tagged him down to 18 and down to death, courtesy of RPK. It's nice to see him get another kill here. Smith with the spray. He's going to put down Pip. leaving Hiko on A again. We've seen this happen quite a few times where he'll try and rotate through vents and get caught in transition. It's really a rough retake.
Yeah, it's a lot tougher, especially with only one vent now, right? So, like, for him to go down vents, he needs to go down really close to Squeaky, close to Hut. So, you can see here, Hiko's a very patient person, and he's just walking around, not showing footsteps, and waiting for that lurk in the lobby.
Nitro still just holding on. The kill on Decon was pretty huge. Just funnels the terrorists out elsewhere. Surprised to be G2 haven't been able to explode onto the site just yet, purely off the back of Nitro just having presence. Shox is in vents, RPK in control room still. And Nitro will go in for another kill. RPK head to head. Hiko is still up on the other site, so Nitro is doing so much work. The pop flash is going to buy him up a little bit more time, especially as that second one hit body plumb in the face. The spray's not quite on point, but is it going to matter? 15 seconds left. JDM just has to hold on. The one taps landing all around JDM. And finally, one will connect. 9 seconds now. Hiko comes through. There's the first frag. Can he get a second one? No, he can't. Scream is there again. Unreal. He's doing so much damage. Finishes on 17 for 11, even though his team only picked up 4 rounds. That is impressive. But the Liege continues to be the boss. 11 to 4 at halftime.
That was kind of scary. I mean, they had a pretty good setup, Nitro, and that new backhaul that's got reintroduced to Nuke, and then JDM at ramp. I mean, Nitro was doing work over there, but, you know, the man advantage finally goes in favor of G2, and getting them 4 rounds isn't enough. I mean, that could be the round that wins it.
It really can. I mean, it's still so many variables and unknowns about Nuke in terms of sort of what's an average scoreline. Is CT as dominant as it used to be? Is it more equal? Some people would even argue that T has a lot more success now. So it'll be curious to see how this one plays out. But G2, on the CT side now, what we do know, they desperately need this pistol. That goes without saying. And they're in the usual positions, really. There's nothing out of the ordinary here.
Yeah, and I'm hoping Liquid doesn't play their T side like they played their T on Train, where they basically just sit and spawn and then just call a strat out of a hat. Like, I'm hoping they're not, like, that tight. They need to be loose, and they need to be able to make plays and, you know, use their talent to open up rounds. So, hopefully we don't see a Train half like we saw earlier.
Yeah, more competitive would be certainly favorable. At least gonna be going through first. He's down to 4. And the Liege gets picked off almost instantly. Nitro's gonna go down as well. This is looking way better for G2. Sure, body got wrecked in the process. Hiko with a burst fire. Not gonna pay out anything for him.
Shox just got 3 really nice like one taps there. He's so patient with shooting too. And just so accurate. Like, Shox absolutely nutty on pistol round. And he just looked super on point there, just watching him the whole time.
What about that for an assortment of weaponry? MP9s, XM, M4s.
G2 used it all.
Bargain buyout here for G2. RPK, only player to eat early damage. I assume that was due to full death. I didn't quite catch what was happening there.
It must have been.
Oh, Smith's now going to be coming up with the M4. 3 kills to him. Scream is going to go down. Hiko spins around. Unable to land that second shot. It's just all too easy for G2 as expected, as anticipated. Screaming on the player to fall. Wouldn't surprise me if we see one of these players drop an MP9 into his hands and then replenish their own weapon. Surely. No? Just goes out for the straight up M4. Okay.
Yeah, so I mean, what Liquid wants here is a bomb plant. Hiko grabbing the smoke here. Maybe gonna smoke out Squeaky Door, maybe try to do what RPK did, run down vents, get a quick bomb plant. But no, they're gonna head towards the ramp here, one smoke.
Yeah, so it looks like it is gonna be a fast ramp hit. Putting the smoke off the wall, banking it off, and then charging through. Scream surely is gonna be the man to do some serious damage with that M4A1S. There's the second one, looking for a third, runs out of bullets, runs out of life. Meanwhile, Pimp comes back for the weapon. And down he will go to Nitro alongside him. So G2 are doing everything they can to get themselves back into this one.
Yeah, and I'm surprised that even went that well for Liquid. I figured they would just get mowed out coming through, like, the double smoke there, so... I mean, grabbing two kills there, not too bad. First gun round. Let's see how loose Liquid's gonna be here.
Yeah, the other rounds have almost been a test for G2. Here comes the real battle. How they're gonna deal with Liquid's aggression. With them. Pretty much what G2 were doing on the roll reverse. Slow and steady. Seeing that G2 really did prefer outside, we didn't really see them aggress on ramp that often, maybe once or twice.
No, yeah, they really didn't touch ramp, like outside a lot, just trying to get into lower. They didn't wrap heaven at all, but they definitely like throwing those smokes outside and denying vision to the CTs.
Shox has done so much damage, not just the kill, but also knocking a Leech down to 8, who has the bomb. And now he's been isolated from the rest of his team, so if this bomb gets dropped here, this is going to be a really horrible place for Liquid to play off. We've seen how potent they were on the CT side. So far, the T side hasn't really shown too much. A Leech, as a result of his low health, you can see him playing this one very carefully. Not peeking out too far. Now, there is a player, I was about to say, that Smiths is peeking out from heaven. And the Leech could get the drop on him. If Leech goes and peeks again here, he could very well just straight up kill Smiths. And he just goes for the spray there and doesn't really land too much. Smiths was right for the taking for quite a while there. That could be what ends up costing Liquid this round. Eco does at least come back in for a kill of his own. He's going to be working off Squeaky. Nice frag from JDM. Smith will drop to his demise. 15 seconds. Hiko could feasibly pull this off. He's going to be smoking to try and give himself some cover. And Shox isn't sure which side of the site he is. He's going to wait. And I love that by Shox. Just waiting. Not giving anything away.
That's so crazy that he couldn't see him there.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's a nice smoke.
Yeah. Patience by Shox. Low HP. Good play by him.
Very nicely done. Realizing, okay, the bomb plant isn't that important. Liquid haven't shown a great deal of potency. Anyone on the T side, get them the bomb plant. Just make sure I get this kill. Make sure there's no chance that Hiko can clutch this round.
First gun round, already a tactical. That's a good thing or a bad thing for them?
I guess it comes back to the, you know, with so many pauses and so many timeouts being allocated now to the teams, that why not? Just like if you're feeling like there's something to discuss in that previous round, something that you noticed that went awry. I
mean, definitely.
Shox really did just screw with them, you know, took a dump in their cornflakes at the very start by getting a frag and knocking a Leech down through that smoke. That really wrecked them. As soon as that happened, they kind of went off the rails a little bit.
Yeah, that was a really good play by Shox. He was like kind of getting in between their wall of smoke outside and just kind of was ninja with it, grabbing one kill, damaging, you know, that other guy. So super good play by Shox, and he's really showing up on the city side. Him and Scream leading the way.
Yep, whereas for Liquid, it is Alish and Hiko that are the two players to watch out for. Speaking of Alish, gonna be setting up a smoke onto outside. JDM alongside him with his flash out. No AWP this time for Liquid. Simply didn't have the funds to accommodate it.
This is a rare sighting, JDM on a rifle.
Yes, he does go for the AWP whenever he's given the opportunity, typically because he isn't the strongest of riflers. We'll have to see if that's going to prove to be the case in this round too. But you are getting towards the finish line now, the final third of the map. And sure, G2 still find themselves at a three-round disadvantage, but momentum is certainly in their way. They have gone unbeaten so far on their CT side. And long may that continue if you happen to be on the GT side of things. 50 seconds left. Only one smoke for Liquid, and Scream is using this position very well indeed. He's hiding behind the boxes, but instantly Elise just barrels out with one kill alongside Pimp. And now ramp is open. And we haven't really seen Liquid in this kind of an advantage so far on the T. Cypher Shox comes through with a couple of frags of his own, equalizing the odds. He's down to 22. But with that smoke on control room, this really plays havoc with the T's. They're not entirely sure what to do. Nitro comes back with a kill alongside Hiko, and Shox will be the last player to fall. So they do salvage it. They do stabilize right at the end. When Shox comes through with that double frag, you're thinking, oh, wow, Liquid surely not going to let this one slip as well. They didn't.
Yeah, and G2 had everyone at lower, so that could have got really scary. Did they actually end up planting on top of the silo? I didn't get to see it.
I didn't quite catch that. What I'm surprised by is another Ports. So Liquid win the round. Ports tactical. Okay.
Okay.
You up, mate?
So they have one more left?
Yes, I believe so.
Yeah, I mean, we had three guys survive, so decent end to what it was, a 3v3 there at the lower site, which a lot of times you'll favor the CTs. But another big round. It's kind of like when they lost, they lost the first round on CT side. They just went for a pause. Like here, this is a really big round, momentum swinging. So Liquid, I don't know if this is Zeus calling these pauses, probably. So I actually like them right now.
This does give G2 a chance to also rummage together a couple of ideas. They're in this very odd situation where their economy is quite spread out, actually. Shock's going through before he got the P250s on 4.6k. His RPK's on 1400. His woes continue, by the way. 2 for 14. It's been quite a rough one for G2. If he can start to show up here, and if RPK can start to get into the gears, then that could be what takes them over the line. If they get all five players churning together.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, you need all five players on Nuke to just be going off.
And he is a guy that's capable of, once he does start to get the wheels turning, he can be an absolute monster. So, hopefully, we are going to see RPK show up. Better late than never. Alish is going to be jumping on top of the vents as Hiko goes in for a kill. Didn't quite catch that. I think it may have been an aggressive play by G2. They are on pistols, so these kind of aggro plays are certainly not out of the ordinary.
Yeah, Shox was walking right into the lobby there.
To be scurrying outside. He's going to see a multitude, a plethora of terrorist members, almost spoilt for choice. In the end, he did lock on to Nitro and put him down. But the rest of G2 have been struggling. A leash on one health. Two kills in the round. Bomb has been dropped out a little bit, but it's easily salvageable. As RPK goes in for a frag. This is what we were looking for. RPK can't get any more done. In fairness to him, though, it's an AK up in his face. And he does get executed.
They're trying to find the bomb.
Yeah, they found it. Being a sketchy spot here. Scream, backflip to a death. 13-8. Liquid regain some momentum of their own.
Yeah, Liege continuing to frag there, even though they only have pistols. Kind of got scared there with 1 HP, had to fight RPK in heaven, but RPK got the one kill and didn't see another guy, so was looking under the ladder. Liege timing him perfectly.
Alright then, G2. What do you have in store? Gonna go for any aggressive plays? It's gonna be back to standards. Looks like standard, no real emphasis putting outside. They don't have an AWP again, so it could be one of the reasons why they're playing more of a centralized, close range defense.
Yeah, Shox is already in the lower site too, but Smith is actually spotting outside, so Shox is just chilling down here playing lower.
Smoke's being set up for outside again by Liquid. G2 not budging an inch, no real reason to. I mean, it's similar to how Liquid played their CT side. They're very happy with just giving up outside and effectively playing more crossfires on the B side, getting players into control room and ramp. So clearly G2 have a similar thought process. Shox is already finding himself just chilling with a smoke in his hands. Hopefully that doesn't cost him his life. He is downstairs towards Secret. It is going to be an A hit. So watch for Shox to suddenly burst into life. Nitro is looking for that tap onto body, but it comes out worse for wear. And the kills are going down ever so fast against Liquid. It's all on JDM, and he's not going to last for too much longer either. Scream with two. And man, if you blink there, you'd miss the round in the end. Over in the heartbeat.
Yeah, it was surprising that Liquid had no one go hut. They were just like everyone following out the squeaky door. So kind of a weird take there, to be honest. RPK actually got into the hut and just completely just made sure no one was coming through, so everyone funneling through that little corridor. G2 wiping it down.
I can see Liquid posturing for quite some time, and it ended up just being a faceplant moment. Players outside exchanging blows, a Legion Smiths. Smiths intelligently just decides to back off. There's no real reason to be trying to go one-on-one with a Deagle, a Leech with a beautiful Huandi. That's one of the reasons why Smiths relocated in the first place, because he was scared about just that happening. RPK goes looking next. RPK, don't do it. Leech is a monster right now. A Scream will come good for his team. Taking down JDM in style. With the headshot.
Ooh,
RPK is really playing with fire.
He deked him through the wall.
It finally goes down. And he's peeking for so long there with the M4. Finally, plays do come up. Trump's 4G2. Leaving Pimp and his Tech 9 and 45 seconds to play with. Yeah, there's a couple moments there where it's like G2 were almost suicidal in their peaks. Leech could have put that round in a real tenuous position for him. But they will take it anyway. Double digits for G2. 13-10.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes you'll see teams being like over peaky on anti-eco rounds just because, you know, they want to just, you know, just get these frags, just, you know, just completely dominate the other team, make them, you know, maybe demoralize them a little bit. Even though it's just pistol rounds, so I mean, that's something G2 used to do a lot.
Well, as a result of some of those kills, RPK down to $0. Body 700. Yeah, some players with a bit of finances to play with. It's just kind of this flirtatious counter-strike on Nuke, where both teams are just kind of poking and probing one another, seeing if there's any weaknesses. Liquids, we haven't really seen any super fast rounds. Like, I'm surprised that neither team has shown any fast A hits, really.
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember any, at least.
Check out Smith's position here. He is in CT spawn, just locking down the outside rafter.
Wow.
He's all in.
That is passive.
That is passive, yeah. Scream too. Look at this setup coming in. Scream's in the gym.
A Smith has actually landed a shot from there.
That is tilting. He grabs two from CT spawn. Where the CT's by.
Oh,
Liquid. JDM. Just gonna save it.
Liquid like, real bro. Real low. You're at CT spawn. Come on, cuz.
Yeah, that's actually crazy that it actually worked out this round, too.
Not just one, but two kills from that position is pretty bad. JDM, in the meanwhile, goes for a pop flash. It doesn't bounce off the wall, just goes straight through it. Just CS things. You see what I was looking for.
Yeah.
Still gonna get two kills anyway, though. 3 seconds left. RPK's in pursuit with the rest of the CTs. JDM with yet another one, and that probably has secured the AWP for himself. The other two players aren't close enough. Valiant holds, but still Liquid on the receiving end of a bit of a loss streak now. It's 3 in a row.
Final timeout. So, JDM has the AWP here. And I don't think we'll be seeing Liquid Force behind it. So this next round will probably be, you know, Tech 9, P250, JDM, all on JDM trying to get a pick here. He has a pretty good spawn, so we saw once where he rushed Squeaky Door, opened it up, and tried getting a mini pick. So that's an option for him, maybe getting a quick outside pick, quick ramp pick, to get that first pick of the round here.
29 for 17, Liege, 24-15, Scream. Good going, boys, but G2 have called correctly. This would likely be some kind of an eco, so they've gone in for XM and an MP9 to try and build up that bank balance a little bit. Plus, against Kevlar, honestly, these two weapons are insanely effective, shredding through them without any armor to protect them.
Yeah, this is going to be close. If you think G2 wins this round, it's going to be 13-12. Liquid's going to have a bye. So this is going to come down to the wire.
You almost have to feel like this could go the distance, honestly. I think this could go into a 30th round easy.
Yep.
From there on out, it's anybody's guess. Curious as well what the other scoreline is, actually, because remember, this game isn't the only one that has bearing over what happens next for these two teams. Na'Vi's match is very important too. But Liquid, nonetheless, are going to try and win what's ahead of them by pushing down into Secret. I'm more curious as to where JDM is going to be pushing in here. It doesn't really matter if the rest of the team get picked off because he's the power play. And he almost has a convoy, has a couple of bodyguards alongside him with their P250s. Oh, getting each other's way. Shox gets four kills in the round. MP9 frags across the board. Beautiful for his economy. 8.8k before he buys him with some nades. Double orps on Nuke. Okay. I'm curious. I'm assuming that one's going to be playing outside or in around A and the other one's going to be ramp. That's what I'm assuming.
Yeah, I mean, Shox just picked it up off JDM there. Hopping around the corner, getting that 3k. Being really hard to hit, jumping around with the SMG. MP9 is crazy up close. Shoots so fast. And then Shox picking up this op. Gonna take it towards ramp with Smith's on the outside rafter.
I wonder at what point Liquid decide to just go, like, you know, full balls to the wall aggression on A. Maybe just try a fast take on the site. Because most of these rounds have been very slow. They've been kind of pedestrian in the pace. We haven't seen any fast hits, really, by Liquid, other than maybe outside now and again, or when they went for a pistol, they went for a fast execute onto ramp. So I'm curious if that's
gonna
like a desperation play that we'll see.
It's going to get kind of scary even though, because G2's going to have so much utility to molly off everything, so.
Yeah, indeed. Now, Shox, I think, was very close to landing a 2-for-1. I think he may have got tagged up through his teammate. They certainly were lining up for him. And Shox intelligently decides, okay, fair enough, I've got the pick, let's just back away. Especially as Liquid have got themselves some kills here. Nitro's already down to the lower site and is doing serious damage to his adversaries. He's got kills and some tags as well onto Scream. Scream and Shox have now got to try and somehow bring this back in the favor of G2. Make it all on Shox with his AK-47. Bomb planted on A. And Liquids. Looking like maybe they can just nick this round from underneath the nose of G2. Shox is peering on every corner. So it's a pretty brutal sight to retake. There are a lot of angles to cover out, a lot of worrisome places. And I like the double peek from Liquid, just making sure that as good as Shox is, he can't kill two players in separate locations at the same time.
Yeah, I didn't get to see how Nitro got to get an entry and get down lower, but Shox getting an entry at ramp and then almost following up on another free frag. And it was just so close that just great Liquid or great shots from Liquid coming into the ramper there, getting some really nice crisp headshots. What are you gonna need coming into Nuke?
Liquid again this time. We've seen time and time again them throw this similar smoke. It's always a Legion throwing it outside. Lots of smoke. You see a carpet of smoke, enough to choke on. No big gaps either. Shox is going to be peeking up now with his M41S. They're going to be lining up for him. Shox can't get any of them. The leech is too fast, and it's good for Liquid that he was, because honestly, in another day, Shox could have picked up two or three kills quite easily there, the caliber of player that he is. The leech in the meanwhile, though, pushing down into connector, but hold on control room, pardon me, but hold on a second, because look at Scream. He's in toxic, and we haven't really seen anyone play this position just yet. He's going to get the one frag. Pip could very well be the next on the chopping block. Down he goes, body with two. G2 out of nowhere, stamping this round in their favor. And Hiko may be able to get a kill, maybe two at most, but it's not likely to be much more. In comes RPK. 14-13, Liquid back into an eco.
Yeah, that positioning from Scream just wins the round. Great job by him. Grabs two from the barrel side. You can just see, even when Scream's shooting at him, there's so many other angles that the terrorists are worrying about. There's a guy in vent. There's a guy at ramp. You know, that man advantage means nothing when you go into that lower bomb site. That's even, you know, that's tough to analyze too, because, you know, they got the entry at outside, right? And then it's really, it just all crumbles once they get into a bomb site. So really, what do you change tactically there, right?
Kills go back and forth outside. Leech has been able to vent dive, but it doesn't have the bomb. It's not under their control anymore. It's actually in a pretty sketchy position. Leech is going to have to go pretty deep to try and reclaim that for themselves. Pimp with a spray. Lands it onto Smith, looking for a second one. Scream. Oh, that reload time is so rough. To be fair, though, he's on low HP anyway. No Kevlar. It's unlikely to get anything done out of this round. Two kills onto G2. Not too shabby by Liquid, considering the lack of investment they had coming through into round 28. More hunting for frags than anything else at this stage. They're not even attempting to go for the bomb. There's an AK. It's going to make things interesting.
Well, hopefully the rest of the team is also thinking about strategies for next round, because they have no more timeouts left and Hiko's actually playing, so he won't be thinking for next round quite yet. So really, Pimp, JDM, and Nitro really need to be scratching their heads thinking of what to bring into next round.
Yeah, it could be one of those moments where they're kind of talking amongst themselves, because they know there's nothing really to lose in that round.
Yeah, they definitely should be. Or at least the people that are dead, I'm saying.
Yeah. 14 apiece. We said it would go down to the wire, and it certainly has lived up to those expectations. And nothing to really distinguish between these two teams so far. The usual suspects are firing on all cylinders. Hiko's having a great game. Leech. He's been so good lately, you're not necessarily that surprised when he lands a 30 bomb, but it is still very impressive.
Yeah, he's doing so well right now.
It's very samey. I've got to say, Liquid, they've done this tactic over and over again. I think G2 are starting to read it, honestly.
Yeah, it looks like they're just going to default here and just go into a set piece. Usually, you know, when a match is this tight, you kind of fall back to something that you've drilled a lot, something that, you know, pull from your, you know, your strat book, like, hey, let's default and then execute X, right?
Oh, Nitro through the smoke. Shox has been in these positions before. Has wreaked havoc. But instead, it is going to be Scream and Smith trying to pull this one off of themselves. Smith's goes down, but Scream does avenge his fallen teammate. Also, jumping back up to the A side, rejoining the rest of his teammates. So they've given up control over ramp, but they are starting to move together as a united force. Nitro outside, though, is definitely going to keep them caught in two minds. Elsewhere, it's RPK that comes in for a kill. And it's going to be JDM who also answers back. So I was a bit surprised that that trade went the way it was. And of course, as soon as I switch away from Nitro, he ends up dying. JDM down into the murky depths of B. I'm a bit worried in case someone's in the control room door. Of course, we have the benefit of knowing that's not the case. And instead, it is going to be Scream who is making a move alongside Body. The idea, two-man death squad. If one of them dies, the other one will avenge the frag. Here's JDM with a rifle. You can hear the footsteps to his left-hand side. It's all about timing, you have to feel. JDM might be able to pull this one off. He opens the door, goes for the spray, but it's not going to work in his favor. Out a bit too early. And G2 will take the lead. Just when it counts too. How's Liquid's economy? Getting that bomb planted and having a bit of round loss could afford them an average-ish buy. Actually, it's a lot worse than I thought. It's mid-$3,000.
The shot Body hit on Nitro wrapping Heaven was absolutely insane. Like, the speed at which he flicked to Nitro's head, like, it was such an insane shot, and like, that won them the round right there. I mean, they had a kit and a smoke going into the bomb, and JDM planted in a, like, planted safe behind the site. Then he went to a position where, like, he couldn't even kill people defusing the bomb. So a little bit of a weird decision there, but that shot from Body was massive.
Back to standard again for Liquids. Managed to rummage together three rifles. Gonna be JDM and Nitro Filtering outside. They have a leech behind them who has the AK-47. Full play is strong. I think we may very well see another secret hit. It could end up going more into main, however. I'll go shocks to his death. That's a pretty important pickup, but Nitro's been tagged down to 12. And although Liquid have got a lot of real estate down in secret, Scream is waiting for them. And Scream has the M4 poised, positioned, ready to strike. Nitro, the first player to fall, did do quite a bit of damage before dying, all things considered. He was very low and close to death nonetheless, regardless of what happened there. The rest of the terrorists are going to be able to try and plant this bomb. Scream is waiting for the rest of his team to get close enough to make a real go of this one. Trade out once again. One for one, and somehow Liquid are coming out ahead here in this round. Scream's will be peeking around the corner. There's the first one, but Pip is not alone. The Leech is also there. That's overtime for the third time tonight here on this stream. We will be moving, if my voice can handle it.
Wow, what a round. I really don't like the decision from Shox in that 5v5 to just pop flash himself through the wall of smoke outside. Like, not only did he give the first entry to Liquid, but also a gun because people had Tech 9s. So, I mean, that was like a really big like decision that really didn't have to happen from Shox.
Where do we go from here, Eric? All bets are off now. Overtime we go. We said it would be close, we said it'd go the distance. I didn't necessarily think it would go to overtime. But here we are. Both AWPers have one for themselves. Let's have a look where Smith is. Outside again, as per usual. JDM, in the meanwhile, is going to be peering down ramp. Liquid back to what they went for time and time again on their T half.
Yeah, starting off slow, making sure they punish any aggression, maybe give some time for JDM to work his op, although he's just holding radio room right now. See where they end up going this round. It was actually a really sick round for Liquid to win, obviously. A must-need round at lower, and all three players were actually in lower for G2, so for them to get the bomb plant, to get back in the door, such a sick play for Liquid.
JDM still not giving up on the potential of maybe a ramp pick. It's going to be Scream that he's up against if he wants to get one. If he decides better off that, goes down into ramp instead. I like this two-pronged attack. Liquid are hitting a ramp, but also at the same time are making a real go of secret. There's a spray from a Liege onto Smith. So they can wrap themselves around on two different angles onto B. It seems to be the case, though, that they're thinking better of this decision. They're starting to move their way back into lobby towards the hut. But G2 aren't really having a lot of this. You can see the body's caught in two minds. Because they lost the first player in this round of Smith's outside, body now has to look into heaven as well. And in doing so, it's going to break his concentration. It's going so heavily Liquid's favor. It's all on Scream. And as much of a beast as Scream is, to get more than a kill, or maybe two from this scenario, is asking a lot. So, yeah,
great job from Liquid at actually end up hitting the upper bomb site that time. G2's been stacking lower a lot, like Scream and Shox both being lower a ton. The ramp player is just dropping into lower, peeking from U-Haul. So I really like the adjustment from Liquid here to go upper.
Scream just wanted to save. Of course, even though it's overtime, the CTs can certainly be pretty heavily punished if you go into the third round and losing ways. So saving this M4 is still worthwhile. Nico drops down that bomb, does significant damage to Scream, but I don't think it's going to be enough to finalize his life. No one else in Liquid is close enough, and here comes the pause. A tactical one in the dying embers of Nuke. Remember, a lot rests on this game, guys. If you've just joined us, we're currently in a position. I don't know how the Na'Vi game's going, because obviously we're focused on this match here, but whoever loses this game is out. It is that simple. So getting knocked out in Group A, in the early stages, in the group stage, it's going to be a heavy body blow to both these teams. They're fighting for a lot right now.
Yeah, nothing like OT fighting for your spot in the playoffs, right?
Indeed. And they will definitely be feeling the pinch. Now, I've got to give a shout out to both these teams, because this has been a long, grueling day. I think Liquid were playing first as well. So they've had like the first and potentially the last game. Again, it depends on how the other match is going right now. I think if Na'Vi win their game against Immortals, then they're on 3-2. The winner of this will be on 3-2, and then we have a tiebreaker where I think those two teams are going to have to play each other. But if Na'Vi lose, then straight up the winner of this goes through, and I think they're joined by Astralis and Immortals.
I believe so. Yep.
But back to the action at hand.
No, I'm on the board for G2 here.
No. I think someone's of the opinion that the M4 and a full 9 is a bit more important right now. Immortals won. Okay, so Na'Vi are out. Wow.
Interesting.
I did not expect that to happen. I think a lot of people would have fancied Na'Vi to maybe even top the group. They have been struggling lately, and that is another case of just that. But let's focus on this game, the action at hand here. RPK is defending off against one of the first raw A hits that we've seen for Liquid, and what a time to burst this out it is. Pimp is going to try his best to get more frags on the board to this round. That could be more than good enough. Smith's is already dead, but Screams is now the man in command, and he's going to get picked off as well. Liquid are moving closer and closer to qualify, going through to the quarters. Immortals, whatever happens with them beating Na'Vi, they will now go through to the semi-finals. That is guaranteed. They finish top of their group. And so Astralis and the winner of this game will go through to the quarterfinals. That's my understanding of the group stage. But Liquid is certainly in pole position, and this is where the economy really stings. Look at that buy for G2.
Yeah, that's rough. And I don't know if that was planned from Liquid, but they threw their execute and just waited until G2 pretty much used all of their counter grenades. And they went out versus a pretty favorable battle. Like, they didn't run into flashbangs, they didn't run into mollies, smoke. So nice engagements from Liquid on the other bomb site.
He's spamming through the smoke. Smiths is going to dodge all those bullets somehow. Still on 100 health. Great dodging skills. RPK. And he's going to have to come around the back of Pimp. Can he land this frag? No, he can't. RPK, what's going on? His woes continue here on this map. He's had a rough one. A 2-1-2. And fair play to G2. They came into this round with a really poor buy. Now they have a real hope, a real chance at maybe clutching this. The bomb is dropped out for Smiths to try and hold on to. He's had a pretty solid performance today at Smiths. And he'll be hoping to get these next two frags. If he does, they're right back in this. If he doesn't, they'll have to win all three rounds on the T half. And remember, both teams only won four rounds in total in regulation.
Yeah, this is actually a massive half from Liquid. And Smith does have somewhat bomb control. He knows it's down at red, but playing a little bit more of an off angle here. She'll be able to catch him off guard, going for a mini, getting back. Smith takes down Hiko. Again, just a JDM. Smith's doing work. 4k on the round.
Man, I thought Body had completely whiffed that, but fortunately they did have that crossfire that you were talking about, so Smith was able to get his 4k as he moves on for 21-26. It's been Scream, though. Again, 35 frags alongside a Liege, neck and neck of those two players. And that one round could be so important for G2. Three rounds in a row was asking a lot. Two rounds is doable. It's still going to be hard, though.
Yeah, I mean, and it's not like they have much to work off of, like, what worked first half, right? Like, nothing really worked for G2 first half, so let's see what they draw up here.
Let's have a look here. How are Liquid going to be filtering out on their CT side? I mean, it's pretty much the same thing we've seen Hiko do time and time again, throwing the incendiary into the hut, and then backing off to the site itself. Pimp is going to be joining him once again. And outside presence has been controlled by G2. It's what they do with it next, though, that really counts. Looks like Secret could be on the cards. Smith just checking to make sure no one's up in the little jump spot there on the boxes. It is a sneaky position. I like that as well. Body actually jumping over, making sure that insta-headshot wouldn't really be on the table. And with him being on 63 health, it makes sense he'd go in first, but JDM is going to land the frag, and he's going to get no more from that confrontation. Elige going to be joining Nitro going downstairs. Throwing out the incendiary, stopping them from pushing out the doors. It's pretty much just the delay tactic there. Stopping them push out the doors, allow Elige to get into position, allow him to put his feet on the ground and try and get that boss fight into play. Decent Wally out, but there's the spray. The bomb gets dropped out onto the site. Pretty rough as far as G2 are concerned. And that E4 is going to continue to rattle off rounds down range. Shocks in the meanwhile comes around the back. This is a really important kill, and it's gone the way of G2. So vital. The spray from Hiko's not on point, and G2 have picked up yet another round, but that could have easily gone the other way if Shox got bested by Nitro on ramp.
Yeah, I don't know if you saw that, but Shox actually had a clear shot on one guy and didn't take it, and peeked out and got the guy that was actually Nitro, like you said. He was actually watching the flank, so he didn't, Shox didn't take the, you know, the first shot that he had available. So that was such a massive play from Shox, and wow, that was such a, just a big play from him.
That could be the play that gets G2 this entire map and gets them qualified. At this stage of the game, with the way things are going, that could be it. All even, neck and neck.
So yeah, there is hope.
At least this time is in secret, and he has JDM next to him as well. We've seen Leech in these positions before. There's the spray. Is he going to be able to survive this one? No, he's not. He gets charged down instantly. Now Pimp is going to dive down the vent. Throws out the incendiary. Stops that push. The thing is, though, that G2 are up to the task. They know what's happening. And they're going to play the mind games. At this point, it's like, Pimp, are you absolutely sure we're going to B? Or maybe we're going back through main towards the A side. And that seems to be the play that they're going for right now. Flashbang though. Well, PK is getting his feet a little bit toasty. The CT is trying to hold on a little while longer. Pimp will not be able to get up that vent. And this is where the double vents, or the lack of double vents, really hurts on these kind of rotates. Because you're pretty much funneling into the one vent. It's much easier for the terrorists to hold off. And much harder for the CTs to retake. They have a player in heaven. Pimp is still in the vent, biding his time. JDM, in the meanwhile, is lurking his way around the back of lobby. It's going to be Nitro for the pop flash into the peak. That's not going to land on anybody, though. Someone needs to make a move here for Liquids. They're taking this incredibly slowly. And it's going to work against them. In go G2. Two rounds out of two. And now it turns out to be them that can possibly just take this outright.
It's not looking good. Yeah, I mean, they win that round and now Liquids absolutely broke. Like, way worse money than what G2 had going into the third round. Because I think Scream saved the one round, so they still had a couple rifles. They're going to have a shotgun, MP9, two pistols, and an ump. And both teams actually changing up their T-sides. They're taking out side control, putting a lot of pressure at secret, and then instead of going lower, which both teams have gone every time, switching and going upper.
Oh, but Elige comes out with a hero place. Two frags for him. Can he find any more? He has enough time to reload, but now he's being encircled. What? How does he get the kill on Shox? That third kill should never be his.
Elige taking things into his own hands, getting a massive 3K.
Jesus, G2, you had this map in the palm of your hand, and Elige just broke your wrist. He took it by force. I cannot believe. Okay, the first two frags is impressive, but that third one onto Shox to the USP against head armor.
Yeah.
That is unreal. G2 still not out of this, still not losing this round guaranteed, but it's got a whole lot more difficult. When you see the weapons they're up against, not great. MP9 XM, but it just takes one misstep. And that will be it going firmly in the hands of Liquid, and we will be into second overtime. Time is also scarce. It's effectively a 5v2 now. Time itself is against this G2 squad. That pick, though, onto JDM is going to alleviate a lot of the pressure. Scream is still lurking into heaven. 25 seconds left now. Desperately trying to get an opening pick here. There's so many angles that you have to be wary of. Body's going to be coming in from the other side.
This is looking scary.
It's all about this cross. If Body can get through onto the silo on the back side of it, then this is now doable. Scream has the back of Body. As the push is going to start to come into play, Body's going to go massive with two frags of his own, and maybe Elise's brilliance is not going to be good enough. Body's on for 4k. He's on for the ace in actual fact, and he's going to maybe take it down. Nitro comes in with the first frag, but he's going to have to stick onto that site, and he's only got an XM. It's pretty trash at this kind of range. Scream's going to go out peeking, And maybe even if Nitro does get this kill, he may not have the time anymore. It's ticking down so incredibly fast. The XM is going to land a couple more shots. Scream is playing. He's biding his time. He keeps going in time and time again. And it looks like it's all over. G2 will be taking this round. And they will be taking this map. Well played in the end. 19-17. What a climax.
What a crazy end. The way G2 got into that situation was amazing. Going up into heaven, body crossing to the bomb site. I don't even know what to say. That was just such a crazy round. And G2 coming up big. Elise just brilliant. It doesn't win the round. Having a massive 3K outside. Like, what do you do if you're Elise? He did everything he could this match.
How depressed must you feel if you're Elise right now? You're like, boys, I just picked up a sick 3K and we still lost. Like, but a body, though, with a 4K, that was beautiful. A double spray, scream up in heaven. It was looking
that
pretty good.
That second kill that body got was just like a spray transfer. It was wild, though. It wasn't like a perfectly good spray transfer. He just kind of just whipped it towards Hutt and just like a random AK bullet just flew into someone's head.
Pretty unreal. I believe that was a 2v5 as well because JDM died just beforehand. It was a 2v4 because Elise died obviously before that, but I don't know, man. My brain is a little bit messed up. I just want to make sure that I don't say anything incorrect here, but I think that might be us done. With Na'Vi losing, I think we do have our top three teams in Group A. I'm just going to double check that to make 100% sure, but I think with those results going the way they did, so we have Immortals finishing top, and then G2 alongside Astralis coming in second and third respectively. So I think we have our top three established right now. Let me just double check that to be absolutely
sure. Yeah, I believe
so. Yeah, I think that we do. So that means that we do have Group B coming up tomorrow. For those of you that may be unaware, that's SK Gaming, NIP, Mousesports, Heroic, Cloud9, and FaZe. I think most people would agree that tomorrow's group is going to be a lot more difficult to call, with a lot more sort of big games, for want of a better term. My brain's a bit melted right now. I've been casting for like 10 hours straight. But it's been a pleasure, Adren. By the way, guys, this is pretty much Adren's first official cast and stuff. He's done a great job, so give him some love. But I think that might be us done. Any closing remarks before we head off, Eric?
No, thanks for carrying the cast, man.
I don't know about that, dude. my brain is melted at this point.
Yeah, a lot of casting. And, I mean, just think about the players, Liquid and G2. To play that intense of a match after, like, 10 hours of CS, that's so crazy. And it was a great way to end the day or the group. Super intense matches.
All right, so thanks a lot for watching, guys. We are going to head off. We'll be back tomorrow for Group B. So we'll have pretty much a similar setup to what we had today, where there are two games being simultaneously played. There'll be one on the mainstream, one here on the B stream. But until tomorrow, guys, take care, and we will catch you later. Have a nice night.